Hey everybody, good morning, this is Dave Williamson, ToyCarCollector.com, coming to you live from Portland, Oregon, live on Memorex videotape. That's right, I'm videotaping this with a JVC camcorder and a portable VCR. No, not really, but I have had those. I had one of the first VCR cameras ever, the kind that you had the camera, and then you had a cord, and then you had a portable VCR with the 120-minute T120 tape, and it was cool. So I'm riding along in the morning out doing errands, but I've got a video for you today. I'm opening up a few older Hot Wheels. You know, when it comes to Hot Wheels, you can't really find very many good ones at the store, because like, if you're like me and you go to the store, every time I go to the store, I see a guy who's already been there before me going out the door with all the new Hot Wheels. So anything that comes in, could be a case of something, could be just a few pieces, they're gone out the door. First guy who goes there every single morning, and I have not found a single store in the Portland area that doesn't have that guy who comes every morning and takes everything good. And what he does with those is either, some people sell them on eBay, but a lot of these guys just take them home and put them in their garage in bins and boxes and store them up until 20 years goes by, and then their family calls up and goes like, my father just passed away and I have this garage full of Hot Wheels and I want to sell them. And I'm like, okay, good luck with that, because nobody wants 20-year-old Hot Wheels anymore. But anyway, on a positive note, this video is me opening up some Hot Wheels that I have bought. A few from here, a few from there, conventions, toy shows, you name it. Toy shops around town, anything I find that looks good, and eventually I've got to open them. I absolutely do. Plus, I've got a couple of new stands. They're actually stands for seasonings, you know, like a spice racks. Got them off of Amazon. Take a look at those, or just one in this video, and I'll show you more in other videos. And anyway, without further ado, let's get started on ripping open blister packs. Alright everybody, here I am at my desk, and I have got some newer Hot Wheels. Ooh, look at all this matchbox. And we're going to go over here to my little studio, and we're going to open up some of those newer Hot Wheels, because that's what I buy them for. I open them up. I buy them to open them up. And today we're going to try out one of my new deals here from my antique mall. I got myself a spice rack. A spice rack to set the cars on in my antique mall. This one's kind of a big one here. I got another couple small ones as well. Let's see, let's set this to the back. This one I got on Amazon. It's actually two pieces. It's got two pieces like this, and they slide together to make an extra long piece. All right, so let's get started. Open up some newer cars. Now, when I say newer cars, I do buy some cars from the store occasionally when the new ones come out. And then when I go to Hot Wheels conventions or toy shows or whatnot, I buy some cars that I never saw at the store or never bought. This one here, starting off, and I call this, when I collect the 58 Ford Thunderbird, these ones are tough to find. I call these my oldies series, and I put them all together in the oldies section of my collection. So let's start by opening this one, the 58 Ford Thunderbird. It's almost a shame to open up all these cars, but you know, you just can't get a real look at them unless you have them in your hands. Look at that beauty. That is a beauty, the 58 Ford Thunderbird. Why don't they make more cars like this? This is fantastic. Fantastic. We're gonna put that one up there just like that. Grab another one. I do have more T-Birds, except this time it's the 63 T-Bird. It's a 63 T-Bird. I do like that one too. Anything about 63 T-Bird is it's all metal. All metal. Metal on top, metal on bottom. Look at that. It's not too many cars like that. This one will really sail down the track with all that weight. 63 T-Bird. Isn't that a beauty? I got another one too of the 63 T-Bird right up there. This one in silver. This one in cutoff packs. I don't know what they did with the top of the pack, but they cut that off, and here is the 63 T-Bird in the silver. Look at that, all metal. Wow, that's an expensive piece to make. Put that up on the rack. See how many
cars that rack will hold. Now let's see, what else in the oldies? In the oldies. Okay, let's see. Oh, I love this one. Love this one. 53 custom Chevy. Look at this thing. Now this one's got damaged tampos on top, but that's okay. And this one, about 2017. So this maybe came out last year. I never saw one at the store. Got this one at a show. And there she is. Look at that. Look at that Claire hood on there. Isn't that cool? Plastic base. That is just cool. Does that hood open up? I never tried to open up the hood on one of these. Not really. Maybe. No, don't think so. But it is there, and it looks cool. So we'll put that one there. I've got two more from that series. I think I've got four or five of them in my collection already. This one, 2007 new model, purple over white, with a chrome interior. Chrome all up in it. Chrome up in there. Look at that. Oh. Feast your eyes on that beauty. Mm-mm-mm. That is a beauty. What year is that again? That is a Chevy. Custom 53 Chevy. Imagine. You can almost see the 55 Chevy in there, right? That part of it looks like the 55 Chevy. Back end with the... a little bit. Take out that roundedness, and you almost have a 55 Chevy in there. Hmm. Interesting. Interesting. Let's see. Those are going to roll off there, aren't they? It's a little bit of a slope. Got one more of the 63s hiding over here. This one, a bronze color over an even other bronze color. This one is a 2006 or 2007 new model. It's like two colors in the new model year. Look at that. See how much prettier that is out of the package? It really is. This one's got the five spokes, which are my favorite. Got the chrome inside. What a beauty. I guess these all have chrome interior, but look how nice those look up there. And then here's a newer one, the 41 Willys. This is a fairly new one here, and 2015-16, and I think they, what if they made this one in red yet? I don't know, but this is really a gorgeous car. I love this one. That is so pretty. Look at that thing. It's just the package. When they're in the package, it just doesn't do them any justice, does it? Put that guy down there. Yeah, let's see. What do we want to add to that? I do like the Bone Shaker. I do love the Bone Shaker. I just saw, I know a guy who's got a Bone Shaker collection, and I think he's got like 50 different ones, and they look cool together. They really look cool. The Bone Shaker, wow. Look at that. You know, when you get enough good Hot Wheels together, it is fabulous. Come on, you guys, don't roll off there. Don't roll off, don't roll off. I will show you a little technique here. See this right here? This is a piece of insulating foam. It's very thin. And what you do with that is you put it on your Hot Wheels car, whatever's sticking out. Here's a piece that's sticking out right there. Just put it right there. Sit on your display. Now she don't roll away. Very, very nice. Very nice. She won't roll away now. 57 Chevy next up. This one, the Valentine's model. Valentine's 57 Chevy. There she is. Nice looking car. Valentine's 57 Chevy. I do have a thing for the 57 Chevys. All the Chevys. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And let's see what's next. How about... oh, let's do these. Oh, those are Camaros. Let's see. Where's those Corvettes? Oh, here we go. I've been dying to open these two. The 55 Corvette. Look at that. One blue, one black. Go ahead and... Mattel, go ahead and make a lot of colors of this guy, because that is one sweet car. Could you imagine having a car that looked about like that? Mm-mm-mm. That would be sweet. Look at all these cars from the 50s. These are cars from the 50s. Oh, man, almost makes you wish you were born in the 50s. Well, born in the 50s. You have to be born in the 40s to enjoy the cars made in the 50s, I think. At least when they first came out. I don't remember any cars when I was a kid. Of course, we were so poor, we didn't have a car. Let's see, that foam. I got this kind of foam recently, but it's just too big. It's too big. I don't. The car won't be able to sit down on it. That is just not the good foam. You got to have the little foam. Got to have the little foam. There we go. Little foam. Here's another piece of little foam. Got them sticking around here on my desk. And you can take them on and off.
Doesn't really matter.
There it goes. Very, very nice.
Let's open up another oldie, a couple more. How about a 62 Corvette?
62 Corvette. Oh, yeah. That would be something. A 62 Corvette. And there she is. Look at that. That is sweet.
Now they need to make this in a convertible, don't they?
Yeah, yeah. 62 Corvette. Did I say 62? Sometimes I said 62. Yeah, we'll put it right there.
Look at that. That one's going to roll off. Do we have any more foam around here? Any more?
I sometimes stick it to my lamp over here. Oh, there's a piece.
Yep. Stick it all around, and it just puts right back on there. Look at that. Isn't that nice? That is beautiful.
That is beautiful. Let's see what else that we got. Let's open up a 68.
69 Camaro. 69 Camaro. Very nice. And now I've got all these loose cards. I got to sort them out and put them away.
Sort them out, put them away in the cases. 69 Camaro. That's a good one. That's a good one. There, it's going to roll off. Okay.
And last but not least, how about a 2010 Pro Stock Camaro? Now, some of these cars, this is a new car I bought. And I tell you what, when you go to the store and you're disappointed by what's available on the rack, make sure you check out next to the cash counter for these half cards, because I got some of my best new cars from the half cards. I like this one because it's a satin black finish. Pretty cool. And with moon eyes. Very neat. I don't know exactly how many cars they make that would go in a series with this car, but it's pretty cool. So we got that one. We'll put that up on the rack. Let's see if we can get these to sit. Isn't that nice? Like I say, this spice rack comes in. It's a two-piece thing. I think it was about $25. And it looks really nice for displaying cars with the chrome. I'm going to put it in my antique mall space, which has racks and shelves and whatnot. This way I'll be able to display some red lines on there. And it looks very cool. So now when I do my red lines, or when I do my displays at the store, I use these clear boxes. Isn't that cool? So you can just set them up there like that. Let's see how that's going to work. Let me set them up like that. And then I got little price things right on there. And it works out real good. That way you can display more cars. I'm like that, sometimes like that. Sometimes I put them like this, too deep. Anyway, probably do it like that. Or maybe I'll just put some like cheapy dollar cars on there. That'll be cool. That'll be very cool. All right, well, that's all for this episode of Rippin' New Hot Wheels. That's right, this is Rippin' New Hot Wheels, and I love to do that with your host, Dave Williamson from the Toy Car Collector. Thanks for joining me. You have a great day collecting Hot Wheels.